Hello viewers, so in the last lecture we had discussed about PDV work, and that PDV work was if there is a process 1 to 2, then PDV work 1W2 is equal to PDV integration from state 1 to state 2, that is the amount of work transfer in a process 1 to 2. Now in the last class we had discussed about point functions and path functions also. And we had seen that work is a path function. Work is a path function, and pressure or thermodynamic properties, pressure and volume are point functions. Functions. Work is a path function and pressure and volume are point functions. Now you see, this is a very beautiful equation. See, in this, on left hand side you have a path function, and on right hand side you have a product of point functions. Pressure is a point function, and this is change in volume. Change in volume is also a point function. If the volume in these two states, if the volumes in these two states are V1 and V2, then this dV will be V2 minus V1 only. This will be V2 minus V1. So this change in volume is also a point function. So here you can see that the product of two point functions is a path function. Okay. A product of two point functions is a path function. So this is a very beautiful equation of thermodynamics. Now we want to calculate this PDV work for different thermodynamic processes. This PDV is to calculate the work transfer in any quasi-static process. This is a general equation to calculate the work transfer in a quasi-static process. So now we want to calculate the PDV work for different thermodynamic processes. So the first process which we are going to discuss is constant pressure process, and the equation of this process is P is equal to constant. Now we will calculate the PDV work. So let us draw a PV diagram. This is a PV diagram for a constant pressure process. So initially the pressure is P1, this pressure is P1, and this process is like this from state 1 to state 2. This is the direction of the process, and P2 is also equal to P1. So volume over here is V1, and volume at this point is V2, and as I have said that this is state 1 and P1 is equal to P2. Now the equation is P is equal to constant, and work transfer is 1 to 2 PDV. So pressure is constant, so it is C is a constant, dV, and volume is changing from V1 to V2. This constant will come out, so this will be V1 to V2 dV, and this will be C into integration of dV will be V. So it is this, and lower limit and upper limit. So C into V2 minus V1. And since the C is constant, this can be written as P1 also or P2 also. So this will be P1 into V2 minus V1. This is 1W2. This is the work transfer in a process 1W2, P1 into V2 minus V1. So you can remember this equation in this way, that the work transfer in a constant pressure process is pressure into V final minus V initial. Okay, instead of remembering V2 minus V1, you remember in this way that it is pressure into V final minus V initial. So this is the value of work transfer. You can use it directly in the numerical problems. Now the next process which we are going to discuss is constant volume process. It is constant volume process. Constant volume process. So the diagram of constant volume process, initially suppose the pressure is pressure and volume, this is P1, this is P1 and this is P2, and the process is like this. It is a straight line, it is a straight line, because volume is constant, it is state 1, state 2, and volume is V1 is equal to V2. Now for constant volume process, equation is V is equal to constant. Since V is equal to constant, then dV will be equal to 0, and 1W2 will be integration 1 to 2 PdV. Since dV is 0, so this will be 0. So work transfer in a constant volume process, in a constant volume process, will be 0. This is in a constant volume process. But one thing is to be noted down here, that only PdV work transfer in a constant volume process is 0. There are different type of work transfers. Okay, so if there are other types of work transfer involved in the system, then you have to consider the value of that work transfer. But PdV work will be equal to 0 in a constant volume process. Okay, so we should not remember this like this, that work transfer is 0 in a constant volume process. We should remember in this way, that PdV work is 0 in a constant volume process. So this is the value of work transfer in a constant volume process. Now next is constant temperature process. Constant temperature process. Constant temperature process. And we know that for ideal gas, PV upon T is constant. Since temperature is constant in this particular process which we are talking about, so temperature is constant, and this constant and product of this constant and this constant will also be a constant. So we can say that PV is equal to constant. This is the equation of isothermal or constant temperature process. The name of this process is isothermal process. Isothermal process. Isothermal process, and the equation is PV is equal to constant. So now let us calculate the work transfer in this isothermal process. First of all, we'll draw the process on the PV diagram, pressure and volume. And since the equation is PV is equal to constant, so this is like a rectangular hyperbola. So this process will be like this. This is the initial state, and the process will be like this. This is state 2, or let me, this initial state is 1 and the final state is 2. The direction of the process is this. Initially the pressure is P1, volume is V1, finally volume is V2 and pressure is P2. Now the work transfer in this process will be 1W2 integration 1 to 2 PdV. This is equal to V1 to V2 PdV. P is C upon V. It is C upon V dV. So C is constant. So we can write it here. It is V1 to V2 1 upon V dV, and integration of 1 upon V is ln V. Okay, it is natural log base E. It is ln V, V1 to V2. So this is equal to C into ln V2 upon V1. And the C is equal to P1 V1 or P2 V2. So we can write here, it is P1 V1 ln V2 upon V1. Okay, so this is the value of work transfer in a isothermal process. work transfer in a isotherm process. So let me write this equation once again. It is 1 W2 is equal to P1 V1 ln V2 upon V1. And since P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 in a constant volume process, so we can write it is also equal to 1 W2 is equal to P1 V1 ln P1 upon P2. We can write in terms of pressure also. So 1 W2 is equal to this. Okay. So you can use these equations directly in the numerical problems. So this was constant temperature process. Now, next is polytropic process. Polytropic process. Now we want to calculate work transfer in a polytropic process. So the equation of polytropic process is PV to the power N is equal to constant. So actually this is a general equation of the processes. If we keep different values of N, we can obtain different equations of different processes. For example, if I take N is equal to 0, this will be PV to the power 0 is equal to constant. That is P is equal to constant. So it is constant pressure or isobaric. It is also called isobaric process. And if I write PV to the power N is equal to constant, and I take V to the power N is equal to C upon P, and V is equal to C upon P to the power 1 upon N. If N is equal to infinite, then this will be 1 upon infinite, that is 0. So this will become 1. That is volume is equal to constant. Okay, this is volume is equal to constant. It is the equation of isochoric or constant temperature process. So for N is equal to infinite, this will become constant volume or isochoric. Its another name is isochoric process. Now if I take N is equal to 1, if N is equal to 1, this will be PV is equal to constant, and this is an equation of constant temperature or isothermal process. Okay. Isochoric process. Now if I take N is equal to gamma, where gamma is Cp upon Cv, specific heat at constant pressure upon specific heat at constant volume, then this equation becomes PV to the power gamma is equal to constant, and this is called adiabatic process. And the PV diagram, we can draw the PV diagram of a polytropic process. So it is like this, that this particular value is for N is equal to infinite because volume is constant. So this is for N is equal to infinite. This particular value is for N is equal to 0. When N is equal to 0, it is a constant pressure process. So in constant pressure process, we have a straight line, horizontal straight line on the PV diagram. In constant volume process, we have a vertical straight line on a PV diagram. And the isothermal process is PV is equal to constant, that is for N is equal to 1. So let us draw it like this. It is like this. This is for n is equal to 1. And gamma is Cp upon Cv, and we know that Cp is always greater than Cv. So this value will be greater than 1. So we can draw it like this. This will be like this. So it is n is equal to gamma. Okay. So these are the curves of different values of n. So Pv to the power n is a polytropic process. That is a general equation of the thermodynamic processes. So let us calculate the work transfer. Let us calculate the work transfer in a polytropic process. So 1W2 will be integration 1 to 2 PdV, and we can write it V1 to V2 TS C upon, it is C upon V to the power N dV. Now C is constant, so we can write it here. It is V1 to V2 V to the power minus N dV. It is V to the power minus N dV. Integration of this will be equal to C into V to the power minus N plus 1 upon minus N plus 1. And lower limit is V1, upper limit is V2. So we can write it C into V to the power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N minus V1 to power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N. Now let us multiply this bracket with C. So we can write this C over here. You can write in the next line. This is C into V2 to the power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N, and C V1 to the power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N. And this C is P1 V1 to the power N is equal to P2 V to the power N. So we can put either this or both of them. So according to our calculation, here we will write P2 V2 into V to the power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N minus P1 V1 V1 to the power V1 to the power 1 minus N upon 1 minus N. So this can be written as W2 will be equal to, this will be P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon 1 minus N. So this is the value of work transfer in a polytropic process. Now if N is equal to gamma, where gamma is Cp upon Cv, specific heat at constant pressure upon specific heat at constant volume, then this process will become adiabatic process. This is adiabatic process. Adiabatic process, and adiabatic processes are when heat transfer is zero. Q is zero. When heat transfer is zero, this is adiabatic. This is the characteristic of adiabatic process. So this work transfer will be equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon 1 minus gamma. This is the equation of work transfer in an adiabatic process. Okay, so we have seen that we can calculate the work transfer, PdV work transfer, in different thermodynamic processes. Actually, the processes of these processes of thermodynamics and the laws of thermodynamics are actually the soul of thermodynamics. If you understand these processes and the laws of thermodynamics, then thermodynamics is not a nightmare for you. It is a very easy subject, very logical and interesting subject. You will learn it, you will enjoy it. So you learn all these processes, and what to learn in the processes. First of all, you should know the name of the process: constant pressure process, constant volume process, isothermal process, adiabatic process, polytropic process. And you should know the equation of the process, that for constant pressure process, the equation is P is equal to constant. For constant volume process, it is V is equal to constant. For isothermal process, it is PV is equal to constant. For polytropic process, it is PV to the power N is equal to constant. And for adiabatic process, it is PV to the power gamma is equal to constant, where gamma is Cp upon Cv. Okay, so you must know the name of the process, the equation of the process. Then you should know the characteristic of the process. In constant pressure process, pressure will remain constant. In constant volume process, volume will remain constant. In isothermal process, temperature will remain constant. And in adiabatic process, heat transfer will be zero. So these are the characteristics of the different processes. Then you should know how to draw these processes on a PV diagram. Okay. Till now, we have discussed PV diagram only. There are other diagrams also in thermodynamics, which we will discuss with in the due course of time. But till now, you should know how to draw the process on a PV diagram. So I have drawn a PV diagram for different values of N. So you can review it and try to understand how to draw the different process on a PV diagram. So if you understand these things which I have told you, then thermodynamics is a very interesting subject for you. Then you can enjoy learning the subject, right? So these are the different equations of work transfer in PDV. PDV work transfer in different thermodynamic processes. So I hope now it is clear to you. So keep watching, keep learning. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.